Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I decided to film a video trying to show you how I set up for makeup appointments if I have a few appointments or trials at the salon. So I do rent hourly, or not hourly, like client by client, a salon. It's my friend's salon. She does lashes here and brows, and I basically come here to do makeup if I have any trials or any makeup, I guess, events in general. It's a really, really cute place. So I'm just gonna show you how I set up for my appointments today. Let me actually just turn this light off. I don't know. I feel like, yeah, that might be a little bit better. Basically, it's this cute little setup. She has a mirror here. And then this, as you can see, is kind of narrow, honestly. It's not very comfortable, but she didn't mean for this to be originally a makeup space. So that's kind of how she had it. But you know, I made it work. Basically, it's that little table here. I bring my own chair, and then she also has this chair here on which I put my case, because the case is a little bit wider, so it doesn't fit on the table. So I have to put it here. And basically I have my clients sit here because that way they're facing the window and I have the lights here. And yeah, so the first thing I do is always put down a paper towel because I don't want to get the table dirty. So I just have paper towels with me, and I just put like, you know, this long here would be good. And then over here, she has some hand sanitizer, some smelly things, her card reader, and then I just have my water here. And then I'll show you what I set up next. I know I don't just have the case. I also have this here, which has the rest of the things I need for makeup. So it kind of opens up like this. I usually like prop it this way. It's not break the window. And then I open it up like this. I have my brushes here, disposables, and all a bunch of stuff that I need. So I'm gonna go ahead and set it up, and I'm gonna show you what it's gonna look like.
The setup I have is actually pretty simple in terms of the table, because I work from here and then I turn here. So the client is here and I'll usually work out of my case, excuse me, because it's just super helpful and I like to, keeps me organized, because I use something, I put it back. I use something, I put it back. So I keep that chair here with that, and then that's the chair where the client is sitting, and then this is the table. So basically I have lashes here that I'll be using today. I use individual lashes more often than strip lashes. Sometimes I'll use strip, but I find that these look better. You have full control of what kind of look you're going for, and they will last longer, and then there's no being scared of like a certain lash like lifting from one corner or the other. And I find that I have full control of the look I'm doing for the bride or whoever. So I have these. This is actually a new brand I'm trying out. I got these on Amazon, and they has like the different lengths here too. I have this collapsible trash can that I got on Amazon as well. It has some trash in there right now, but I usually will put like poop bags for dogs in here, like, because it's like a smaller size. So I don't have any right now, so I'm just throwing it in here, but usually you can put like poop, doggy poop bags. Then I have like the skin prep section here. I have my hand sanitizer because this one smells really, really good. So your hands smell nice when you're next to the, near the client. Then I have some alcohol here for just disinfecting. I have some Fix Plus from MAC. I spray this sometimes on the skin beharthand. I have this micellar water to cleanse the skin on the client beforehand also. This is a step I will never ever skip. I prefer the Payot makeup removing micellar water, but this is just what I have for now, and I'm just using it up. And then I have a toner always to wash off the micellar water, because you never want to leave that on the skin. I have this one right now. This is actually my friend's. She left it in my bag. She was using it. She let me use it for a little bit. It's the Vitamin C Beauty Seaweed Glycolic Acid Exfoliating Face Toner. And I like that it has a pump like this. So I'll usually use that right after. And then I have some cotton rounds here for that and for this. Then I have hyaluronic acid from The Ordinary. I prefer to use hyaluronic acid on customers, along with like creams. It just depends on their skin, but I prefer to do like a gel, like a hyaluronic acid type of thing.
And then I have this Pawpaw multi-purpose soothing balm. It's a huge size, as you can tell, and I use this on their lips. Make sure that their lips are getting hydrated while I'm working on their makeup. And then I have my brushes. This is like a brush holder thing. It closes like this. And then I have this here because I will put my dirty brushes in here and then I keep the clean ones here. And then I have more paper towel, and then this is the palette I work from. This is from the Beauty Blender. It's like an acrylic palette, so I'll put all the foundations, concealers, liners, anything like that on here to keep it sanitary. And then usually here I'll use, like, if I need to get something from there, I'll put it here. And then here I have just the two main palettes I think I'll be using most likely on the clients. Today I just put out this one from Huda Beauty, the Naughty palette. It's amazing. And then this one by Line Crime, the Venus, super popular as well. I can't open it with one hand. Looks like that. And then I have just more paper towels here, and then the client will sit here. This chair is nice because this also comes up like this, so if they want to put their phone, their drink, whatever, that's cool, but we don't need that. And then I guess I'll give you a little overview of my bag here. So this closes like this, so I'll open it up and I'll work from here. I have the rest of my brushes here for eyes. So I have brushes, I have a spatula here, I have red and burgundy lip liners, more brushes, a bunch of my most used lip liners, eyeliner brushes, some brow products, some liners, mascaras, more liners, tweezers, lash glue. Here I have complexion products, I have these two primers, I have some foundations, this Body Glow thing, Bare Minerals foundation that I really never use. And then here I have most of my other foundations. They're from NARS. They're the Radiant Creamy Foundation. And then they have the Face Atelier foundation. It's amazing. I have the lightest shade here. And then also the Embryo Lisse, but I depotted it into this little thing. It's so, so good. I'll use that to hydrate the skin. Here I have some cream shadows from Stila. This is Kitten. And then I have some of the Danessa Myricks shadows also, or like they're like tints. This is like the Color FX cream colors. I have brow gel, more brow gel, more black brow gel. And then over here, I have more foundations. And then I have some lip products here. Over here. And these ones are from Artist Kit Company. So good. So many lipsticks fit here. You don't need to carry like a ton. This is like amazing. And it's literally the size of a credit card. It's so tiny. So that fits right here. And then over here, I just have a powder for brightening up underneath the eyes. And then some color correcting concealer. Here I mostly have like brow products, a gel liner in brown, my favorite Cosmic Urban Decay eyeshadow, more brow stuff, and then just like singles of like random eyeshadows. Also a single pigment from Inglot. This is like gorgeous actually on the lids. And then I have like tiny lip liners in here that don't fit here because then they get like lost. So I just did this with them because I just like love the colors. I have a Painterly paint pot here, cream contour, more brow stuff. As you can see, it like doesn't fit. I need like a better organization. Favorite gel liner. And then we have another eyeshadow thing, actually. Sorry, I just got interrupted. A cream contour stick, more. This is a primer from Tarte, pore filling. And then I have some powders from Jane Irondale, a Dior highlighter. Some palettes. These ones are from Tarte. That's from ColourPop. And then the Makeup by Mario palette is here. And then his lip palette as well. It has all his lip colors. And then this is from Graftobian. It's like a cream slash toning veil slash like primer. And then another one by Milk. And then this one from Jaclyn Cosmetics. It's the duo with the powder, or I'm sorry, the bronzer and the blush. And then
Over here, I have some highlighters. This one is from Inglon. This is from Juvia's Place. And then I have this blush from Dior. And then I have some MAC blushes, more powders, blushes, setting powder, more setting powder. And then this is a contour bronzer thing from Tarte. And then this little palette that I made from MAC that I use often as well. And then the rest of everything I need stays over here. So I go in here if I need to grab something, more lashes, makeup removing wipes and things like that. That's it, you guys. So this is kind of how I set up for my clients. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you found it helpful. And if you have any questions, leave them down in the comments below. I'll answer any questions you have. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.